Can you confirm for me that the Gateway Project in New York was listed as the number one project on the Trump administration's priorities list? Do I have that right?
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
I don't think there's a list.
Well, I think you identified major projects of national significance, and it was the number one project. But stipulating the importance of the project for a minute, you'd agree with me it's an important project.
We want to work with the states. The issue is how to fund it and what the proportion of shares are.
Right. So the Washington Post reported, Secretary Chao, that President Trump recently personally requested that Speaker Ryan block the federal funding for the Gateway Project in the omnibus spending package. What can you tell us about that? Is that true?
I read it in the newspapers, just like you did.
Right. My question was, is it true?
It probably is.
And can you tell us why the president is seeking to block funding?
I think you need to ask the White House on that. But I have already said...
Secretary Chao, excuse me.
I will be more than glad to explain it if you let me. I've just said that to you numerous times to the New Jersey delegation, and apparently my answers are not good enough, but I don't have...
I think it's fair to say they are not good enough to come before Congress and to say I have to ask the White House when you're the
Secretary of
Transportation.
There's no agreement, first of all, between New York, New Jersey, and the federal government.
My question was much more narrow. My question was, is the President of the United States personally intervening with the Speaker to kill this project?
The President, yes. The President is concerned about the viability of this project and the fact that New York and New Jersey have no skin in the game. They need to step up and bear their fair share. They are two of the richest states in the country. If they absorb all these funds, there will be no other funds for the rest of the country.
Thank you for confirming that. And is it also the case that the administration has rejected the 50-50 partnership developed by the Obama administration?
I may be wrong.
Excuse me, if I could ask my question, ma'am. Thank you. Proposed to eliminate CIG funds, proposed to eliminate Amtrak funds, tried to block all omnibus funding, and now, with your confirmation, threaten other lawmakers with the loss of their project and ask the Speaker to personally kill it. So is it fair to say that the states aren't doing enough when this is the administration's sorry record on this project?
Sir, that is your characterization. It takes me too much time to have to answer every single one of those misstatements. And
Mr.
this
Chairman,
is said with the greatest respect.
What was the question?
How much time do I have remaining?
200. two minutes and 4 seconds.
Well, Madam Secretary, you may have my remaining 2 minutes if you can do your best to explain
Absolutely.
Why the President of the United States is
to.
Killing the most important infrastructure project, certainly in the Northeast, probably in the country, and why it has actively undermined the efforts of the previous administration to work out the very issues you just addressed. Please take my time and tell us why this project, which is so important, is being killed personally by this president.
Those are your words, not mine. If you want the president's stance, please go to the White House. There is no such agreement. The previous administration made no commitment except at a political rally in the heat of a campaign. There's no documentation evidencing any commitment. There's no pending application on the 9 projects that you collectively call Gateway. The career staff rated this project as not eligible for federal funding because the state and local government have put in 5% in one, 0% in the other. That's not how these projects are financed. One of the projects is thinking about applying for a TIFIA loan. They're taking that loan and making it their part. The state is taking our loan and using it as their equity. That's like if you're getting a mortgage and you have to put 20% down as your equity. You go out and you get a second loan and you call that second loan your equity. Well, there are certain guidelines in which these loans are put together. As an example, if you look at the purple line in Maryland, it's 38% federal grants, 33% TIFIA loan, 20% state, 9% the private sector. And I-66, right here in Virginia, the private sector put in 42%.
Ma'am, I'm familiar with how the TIFIA program works.
25% is public activity bonds with no federal funding.
Yes, I'm very familiar with how the TIFIA program works, and I understand those comparisons. I'm also struck by something you said, which is that we cannot ask you about the administration's positions in this room.
No, you can.
But I have to ask the White House about something as important as the Gateway Project.
Yes, please confirm
I understood you correctly on that.
Yes.
Can you explain why?
Gentleman's time has expired.
That's
how it works. Please feel free to answer. I'll stop asking.
No, that's how it works. I don't speak for another person unless I'm there personally.
Thank the gentlelady. Thank the gentleman.